Hey guys, before we proceed, can I just ask one thing from all of you? I understand that we are supposed to end at 8:30, but I feel like for the very first input in reading, I need to be able to make use of like at least 45 minutes for this one. So is it okay if we push our schedule a little and end at 9 or at least 8:45? Would that
yes.
work, you know, with you?
Okay.
So it's fine by you. Okay, perfect.
We'll
all right. And it's likely to be, well, did you get some advisory from your workplace about what's going to happen tomorrow? It's going to be like some storm tomorrow.
Rain.
Just simple rain. So
it's
still
work
a work day.
Tomorrow,
right? Jill was hoping that it's going to be declared no work day in her office. Well, it's now almost 8 and no feedback yet, so it looks like it's going to be regular work day for her. Anyway, let's not talk about reading, everybody. Now, the things I'd like to talk about in reading mostly revolve around methods, ways to look for answers. And that is because in the actual test, guys, you are given only an hour to complete or answer a total of 40 items. Take a look at the format on the screen here. It's similar to the listening test in terms of word count, but the amount of time is 1 hour. And that's both for writing the answer, getting the answer, I mean, and writing them on a separate answer sheet. So you have to be quick. Now, in the case of the kinds of reading tests, there are actually two kinds. Roby over here is taking the academic module, which means she would have to tackle a total of 3 long passages of at least 900 words each, whereas the majority of all of us here will have to deal with short texts, 4 of them, and only 1 long passage. So GT students are luckier in that respect, okay? But take note, it can be very tricky, so good comprehension is key here in this test. Now, let me talk about the one and only very important tip I'd like to talk about tonight. And let's see how it works for all kinds of questions in reading. Now, just like in your listening earlier, I'd like you to always read the questions first, all the time. So in reading, you always start with the questions. Why? Because you need to know what you're looking for. It is not just passive reading, you have to read actively. So knowing the questions, therefore, will let you know what you have to look for. Now, there are a number of things that you get from reading the questions first. One of which is that you will be able to predict where the answers can be found. Now, in a test where you are racing with time, you need to have a way, a method, to determine where probably the answers are found, so you can quickly refer to these lines and get the answers more efficiently. Now, secondly, by reading the questions ahead, you also know how the answers are going to be presented. And generally speaking, there are only 2 possibilities. One is that the answers will be arranged in a sequential order, meaning the answers follow the same order as the questions are given. Or the answers can be randomly arranged. There's no particular order. Number one could be found at the end of the passage, number 2 at the beginning, and so on. There's no order. That's important because it will again let you manage your time better. The third and the most important reason why you have to read the questions first is that you need to know what method to use to look for the answers. Okay, now we would like to share with you guys these 3 methods. we call them scanning. The other one is to skim. And the other one is to read in verbatim. Okay, now tonight, the bulk of our discussion will be about all of these three methods here. Okay, so let's start with scanning. Now, scanning, guys, is very similar to skimming because these two reading methods are called selective reading processes. And we use this method, or we look for the answers, I mean, via keywords. Keywords that often come from the questions themselves, all right? So by knowing, therefore, the keywords, we will now be able to predict where the answers can be found. Let's give it a try. Let's take a look at page 7 and check out one kind of question. Take a look at the instruction at the top left corner of this text. It says there, classify the following plants as migrating by using A, sea or wind, B, the animals, including birds, or C, neither of the two. So your job is to identify how the 7 plants listed below migrate or spread out. Is it by sea or wind, animals, or neither of the two, meaning something else is used. Now, for the scanning method, guys, we use this if the question asks us to classify. The other occasion also in which this is used is when we are asked to match. And again, you will know this from the instructions given in the question, right? So how do we do that? You will find, guys, that the answers in scanning will be randomly arranged. There's no order. However, the method is relatively easy, and you will find that the answers can be quickly found. Let's take a look at one example. Say this is our text, plant migration. The way you scan, guys, is you need to be able to move your eyes in the flow, or using the flow of the text. So you go from top to bottom, you go left to right. So you go top, left, then right, bottom, then you go up and down, left and right, I mean, it would look something like this, all right? So you zigzag your eyes across the text. You don't have to understand what you're reading. You just need to scan for the words, those names of plants listed over here, okay? Now, once you have located those keywords, you highlight them. And you're very, very sure now that the answers are just around those highlighted items. That is scanning. You scan through the text using the keywords provided. The good thing about classification and matching kinds of questions is that the keywords are already provided to you. And that's the questionnaire. That's over here. So keywords are provided already. Now, since this is selective reading, what you're supposed to do now is just read around those highlighted words because the answers are just around there. Let's confirm that. There's a given example here. You'll be doing this on your own in a short bit. Okay, but let's take a look at one, the coconut palm. The coconut palm is quoted there at the second to the last paragraph. It says there, oops, that. Let me go to this one here. Okay, it says there, the coconut palms, on the other hand, produce their seeds inside a shell, which floats on the surface of water and can be carried hundreds of kilometers by the current. So there are two clues here. We have water and current. It's clearly the sea. Therefore, the answer is A. Take note, we just read that part of the text. We did not read everything, right? We just basically got the location of the answer by scanning the keyword, and there we found the answer already, all right? Now let's take a look at the broom. The broom is quoted at the top, the second highlighted item there. It says here that the broom, the seeds are contained inside pods. Heated by the sun, the pods explode, hurling the seeds in all directions. So what therefore causes the seeds to migrate?
Sun.
It's the sun, correct. It's not the wind, nor the water, nor the animals. Hence we write sea. Okay, how about the blackberry? The blackberry is at the bottom. It says here, produces stems which move at a speed of about 5 centimeters a day. When these, the stems, meaning touch the ground, they put out roots, thus extending the plant's territory. So what causes it to spread out is the what?
The stem.
The stems. In other words, the plant itself. Therefore, it's not the wind or the sea, nor animals. Therefore, we say neither again. You guys follow? So what we do is first look for the keywords. We move our eyes zigzagging throughout each section. Once we find the words, we highlight them. Since you'll be using pencils in the actual test, you know, really encircle them boldly or in bold, you know, strokes, for example, and then read around those clues to get the answers. Now, can you please confirm whether numbers 4 to 7 are correct? Please read through them, read the clues highlighted, underlined fully there, and see if the answers are correct. Okay, the cotton, it says here, travel long distances on the breeze. That's the wind.
Yes.
It's A. The burdock is there in the second to the last paragraph. Are attached to hooks. These at the fur of passing animals. Animals, it's clearly B. Birdcage plant is the first one. Blown across plant's habitat. You have clues there. It's clearly the wind. And the durian. Do you guys know what a durian looks like?
Smells like.
Smells like, for sure. Yeah. We have lots of durian in my home country. How about in Czech Republic? Have you tried that?
No.
Have you seen one?
I'm not sure.
Okay. Google it. It's one of the most exotic fruits out there. It's pretty interesting. If you happen to go to Asia, it's pretty common all around Asia. In my country even, especially. So, how about in Brazil, Fernando? No idea.
No.
Okay. All right, so it says here, the fruits or the seeds are eaten by squirrels and orangutans. And then they eject them with their feces, and from there the plants grow. So it's the animals, it's letter B. So that's how scanning works. And it is applicable for both classification and matching type kinds of questions, all right? Let's give it a try. Please go to page 9. We have here a typical short text in a GT questionnaire, Museum of Immigration. Look at the instruction below, bottom left. It says what? Can you please read, Roderick? Rod, yes, the instruction.
Classify the following exhibitions.
So, write A if it's I, if it's interactive, A for audio, B for visual. Now, the A part and the B part are easy. Audio means the sense of hearing. You're on the right page, Fernando. That was page 9.
Right there,
correct. Visual is the sight. But when it's interactive, what does it mean? If it's an interactive museum, what does it mean? Like when you say an interactive game, what kind of game is it?
Online,
among others, yes. What's an interactive?
You can like play with it and interact on what you do.
It interacts, it reacts on what you do.
Yeah.
So for example, in a video game, if you press B, it fires.
Mm-hmm.
If you press A, it jumps, so you see? So when you do something to it, it does something in return. That's interactive, okay? So let's give it a try. Can you please look first for the word journeys, harbor master's house, bathers room, south pier, who and why? Can you please do it now? Look first for those museum names. Once you found names, please check what kind of exhibitions they are.